projects, but I am covering more of infra projects because our maximum use of steel is in infra projects.
See, this is our purchase data. So we purchased close to 3,800 crore last financial year steel alone. In that 2,000 crore is rebar, 1,700 crore is structural steel. So this is not covering the overseas job, it's only the Indian jobs. And of course, you can see the plates, which is mainly for your water supply pipes, then other infra projects. And of course, you name anybody in the field, they are with us, they work with us because of our volume. So all these fabricators, steel manufacturers, so they are working with us. I hope I covered most of the prominent people here, because maybe few people will have covered. Of course, we are here in this building today, and this structural steel was done by us. Of course, designed by Design Excellence, executed by us, very complicated curved element. And this is before covering with the stainless steel cladding, these are the structural members in this hotel. So morning there were lot of discussions about, you know, how to use steel, how to combine, you know, composite, whether it's effective for all kinds of projects. So we have done recently one project for AP Secretariat. They want to hand over the building in 5 to 6 months. So what we have done, we have gone for a combination of in-situ concrete, precast concrete and steel. So that's how, you know, we could achieve this very effectively and also with the minimum cost, possible cost. There's some photos here.
So I made a point.
So you can see this, that's a precast element as a main beam. Then the secondary members are steel, then we have a deck sheet. Then we have a steel concrete over there. Of course, the columns are in situ. So we have gone for an effective combination of all the three. And this building we have completed almost 95% of the work in 5 months. It's a 4 lakh square feet. And balance of finishing work and MEP works in the another last month. So this is the thing we are doing right now. This is in the foundation stage. It's a 500 feet Sardar statue in Gujarat. This is on a riverbank and 3,800 ton steel. Of course, structural consultant, the basic design is by Arun, detail engineering by us. And this structural steel we have given to Eversendai. I think anybody from Eversendai here?
Yes.
Ah, yeah. Okay. But here, if you see the thing, we have only two legs at the bottom for the stability. So we are putting two RCC core. Here again, a combination of, you know, concrete and steel. So through the two legs will be RCC core, and then all the steel members will come. Then we will have a bronze cladding. So bronze cladding is a main item here we ordered from China. And this is going to be the most complex job. Maybe in the globe itself if we complete this. So I hope Eversendai will definitely do it. So this is the initial stages. So the Mumbai airport we have done, this is one of the most complicated roof structure we have done. This is 40,000 ton of structural steel. So this is some of these photos and some erection scheme. Actually we had one separate session in one of the Alien Steel Summit, exclusive presentation on this job, which was a separate presentation on this job alone. I just put only few photos here. The Delhi also we have done, it is from the 26,000, you know, ton of structural steel. So some photos of Delhi. Bangalore airport is a very unique airport. If you see the first one, we have gone for a concrete precast roof. This is, I think, first time maybe that kind of roof we have done. It's 110 ton, you know, precast element with an outlet kind of glass. But when we go, went for phase 2, we could not do that because there's a big project of erecting the element. So we have to go for steel again for phase 2. So this is again designed and built by us. Of course, contract was
geodesic with this.
And this is a doubly curved shell. In steel, doubly curved shell is little difficult to do because every coordinate is different. So all your morning we were discussing about casting of nodes and joints. So if that kind of things are there, it is very easy. But doing in, you know, fabrication element with the bolts, it is complicated. But they have done a very good job here, geodesic. Here some of these project photos. And there was some specific problem. We combined phase 2 with the phase 1. The RCC column was not able to take that load. So they don't want to transfer any moment to the RCC column. So what we have done, we put a double side hinge. So it will allow the movement in both the ways. This is called a knuckle joint. Carol, I think I definitely need a... Anyway, so if you see here, this will allow the top and bottom will allow one side movement. The center one allow the other side perpendicular direction movement. So it will only transfer the vertical load and shear, not the movement to the existing RCC corner. So that is how we manage this. But now of course this is covered. You cannot see this in the airport now. So this is the Oman Salalah Airport. Again designed and built by us. We handed over. This is one of the very good airport recently done in overseas. Then Hyderabad Airport also we have done. But of course initially it was a China State Corporation. This job, so we have taken over from the from China State. We completed this Hyderabad Airport. Right now there are three projects going on. Kannur Airport in Kerala. This is a steel structure. Then we are doing a Cochin Airport. This is again a steel structure. So Chandigarh Airport was already handed over. This is with the node joint. Three-dimensional node joint. Some of these Chandigarh Airport photos. So Wankhede Stadium in Mumbai, another very good project for steel. Consultant was Mahindra. Mr. Mahindra is a hope right here.
Yes.
Yeah. So they have done a very good job of designing this, executed by Optomec. Project was with us. The Hyderabad Metro right now going on, there are 66 stations, of course Kirby Mr. Raju is here, he has done part of this. So initially we have gone into this shape, then we put a standing seam or a sheet, then we had a lot of problem of curving that shape because of steel curvature. So it was delaying the project and we were not able to properly fix it. Then halfway through we changed the shape to this shape. We made it slightly simpler for sheeting, so it was very fast because already there was a pressure on the timeline. Then of course last steel day here I made this presentation of my atmosphere, which was the most complicated sky bridge we have done in Kolkata. So with four bearings, each bearing costing 2.5 crore. 3 meter by 3 meter is the bearing size. Okay, with allowing 250 mm movement on both sides. So last year I made a specific presentation on this case study. So these some of these photos and how it was erected. Using the strand joint we erected this. And Sea Woods in Mumbai, this is in Navi Mumbai. So we have 3000 tons of structural steel and there is a connecting bridge here. So that was again lifted by strand jack. This tower last time in Chennai when they connected steel summit, we presented this case study. This is again 120 meter high, just facing the sea. For a high wind, it is designed for 600 kg per square meter wind load because of that shape, the bowel shape, and a very, very complicated steel. This again done by Everson, they have done extremely well in this going, you know, structural steel. And Passat also was very complicated. It was done by Miro, Singapore. And right now this is going on Kingfisher Tower in Mumbai. This again Everson is doing. We had this, sorry, at the top level there is a cantilever projection.
at the penthouse. It's a penthouse for Mr. Vijay Mallya. Now I'm very income and occupancy.
So we are doing this project. Prestige is the promoter. So this is again, we have very complicated main trusses. We erected using strand jacks. You can see the lifting and going to the top. We have a unique steel called the cotton steel. See, the cotton steel, the specialty is first it will get rust. Once its rusting is over, first coat, then that itself will protect the steel further. And we will not paint this, we will leave it as it is. And it will have very high durability also. It's a special alloy steel. So, architect is from Japan, he specifically wanted this, rusted look for this museum. So that's why we have given this cotton steel arrangement. Also, when you talk about infra projects, our metal handling division, they developed a stacker recliner. This is totally steel, but they used finite element method very, very effectively to optimize this for a very long boom. So this is the first time in globe we had such a long boom for that capacity of that stacking material. So this is a finite element model. So this is the largest capacity steel frame stacker in the world. They are used for Adani port. Again, transmission tower is one of our big business. We actually buy nearly 1.5 lakh tons of structural steel for transmission tower, only for this business division. And this is the tallest tower so far we have done. It was for Saudi, but done in Chennai, in our Pondicherry factory, fabricated and checked at Kanchipuram testing yard, then shifted to Saudi Arabia. So these are testing facility we have in Kanchipuram. So that's in Asia, that's the biggest testing facility for transmission towers. Of course, now solar is picking up, and we also need a lot of steel for solar, even though the structure is very simple. So this is the structure, but the volume will be enormous. We will go for more and more solar. So how to optimize even this? Even 5%, 10% reduction every time you do that, you will save a lot of steel, because the volume is going to be very huge here. And some of these factory structures, this is a limestone storage shed in one of our steel cement plant, now it's UltraTech cement plant. It's a 108 meter dome with a conveyor hanging at the top. That's giving almost 8 meter point load. So we put a geodesic pattern which is very, very effective on a dome shape. We optimize the steel by going for that shape. All your joints are with the friction grip bolts. So this is some kind of detailing. So the junctions are being detailed out. And we have developed a perfect hinge at the column support point. So it's 100% the hinge. So this is another type of dome with radial thrusters and compression ring. This is for again a large span below this. So this is a clinker silo in a cement plant, which we have to design the steel for 120 degree temperature also, and the clinker is very hot. So this is a 65 meter diameter dome. We fabricated everything in the ground floor, it's around 730 tons. Then we lifted it and put it in place with the 16 strand jacks. So the lifting took almost 6 hours. So we could place it in position. So after finishing this thing, and we had a strand jack at this the perimeter. The same cement plant, there is a Hillock conveyor, because the main plant was at the top and the cement silos were at the bottom. It's 80 meter deep Hillock. So this conveyor gallery again, we have to do totally bolted connection. And because vehicle cannot access, we cannot go and weld it, people have to manually carry the members. So we have to take member by member and assemble it with the bolt there. This is a Oman, one of the cement plant, totally bolted above ground. No welding allowed at site as per their norms. So it was fabricated in Dubai and shifted to Oman and erected. Another view of the same similar building. And this is for a Coca-Cola plant. They don't want to see a normal truss. They want some elegant looking truss. So they got for a A-frame. Even though well-placed,
slightly more, but it looks fantastic, you know, look, compared to a normal press.
And also we are into many other infra projects, nuclear containment, we'll have a big steel dome. Then water pipeline is another cross, I mean, cross country, air cross, you know, city pipelines, up to 2.1 meter diameter we are doing. And underground metro stations will have a lot of steel again. The railway electrification is another big division, you know, they are using extensively steel. And recently we are now facing lot of, I mean, we are working with lot of multinationals like GE, Alstom, Boeing, and their requirements are very, very stringent. Of course, I could not put some photos of what handle we are doing. It's a defense project for an overseas client. There we come into some problem.
So I can highlight those few things.
North side normally we don't
take it very serious. Maybe the steel fabricator, electric equipment, they know what is the problem as I mean.
So this creates weakness in the main parent material. When to do the welding, slightly when this, you know, electrode got shifted due to some, you know, problem. So it's affects the parent material. So this has to be properly grinded and checked for soundness.
So now most of the time we don't even bother about this, but in this job we have to check each and every element for this.
Then the weld access hole we have to give.
And there is a full of weld welded, you know, girders or columns.
Those weld holes
are not supposed to be filled with weld. We have to leave that hole. Otherwise there will be a lot of stress concentration at the point.
So here again,
few cases there was, you know, it was filled with weld, they made a big issue, so we have to again redo that, you know, fabrication.
And this is all based on American Welding Society specification, AWS.
Today, all the foreign people, they refer AWS, which is totally different from our IS 800 for welding. So we have to really understand AWS in, you know, what we know, overseas people.
And preheating is again prepared for high thick plate. This depends on the plate thickness. Most of the time, 40 mm and above, you may have to do preheating. And depends on electrode and methods of welding. So if this is not done, your welding will not be proper for you know, highly loaded structures. So this again, we have to properly record
all those documents. So we have to check
the preheating. Okay, morning in this panel discussion, this was discussed.
China, they have done.
It's a 57-story building they have done in 19 days.
So we visited this. There's a group of people. McKinsey has arranged. I don't know anybody is here in this photo. From India, a lot of people have come. RMZ, Tata Housing, and many people have come.
So this, at the bottom, we are taking the photo. It's called J57, this building. Due to some NDA signing, I cannot give the detail of this project because it's confidential. But we know how they have done it. They have done totally, it's factory net and erected. 57 stories in 19 days. You cannot even imagine in India we can do this. Morning this was discussed, it should be totally fabricated, you know, off-site and bring it to. So, but we know how it was done. We have visited the factory also. So, but I could not give the detail today because of some India
agreement. But what is the project
schedule? No, see, this is having a two basement. So the two basement they have taken around 3 months to construct. So that time they effectively used for engineering and fabrication of all those decking, columns and decking. Of course, 1 month before, so after 4 months they started erection. After this, most of the finishing work is done at this stage itself. Then after the erection, some, you know,
wet finishes of, it's a hotel, so there will be some wet finishes which they have taken another 3 months. So total I will say 8 to 9 months they have done the entire week, I mean maximum 10 months, which itself is a very big, you know, record.
And this is a hotel we stayed in the same campus, it's a Dundee Broad Group, both are in the same campus. This is a 15 story building they have done in 9 days, we stayed in this hotel, everything is perfect, absolutely no problem. Very good finish, very neat, very clean. They also checked for earthquake Richter scale of 9, these kind of designs. They have modeled and checked that also they showed us how they have done the testing. So absolutely no problem for safety. So now this is what now we have to think in future. How to do this? So maybe today in the panel discussion again I discuss something on this residential building, how to go forward, and there is a shortage of time. Thank you.